So all of us, when we were kids, we knew one child who never wants to go to school, who'll make absolutely ridiculous explanations to bunk school, telling his grandfather that his teachers are vampires, hiding his school shoes behind the WC, by sleeping with ice in his pajamas so that he would get a cold next morning. How many of you knew such kids? Well, I wouldn't know because I was that kid. And FYI, that ice in your pajama trick never fails. You know, if I was lucky enough, my mom would allow me to bunk school. And I would consider myself even more lucky when in those days, my dad would take me to his stock broker's office. I still remember the days I used to hold his hand while entering the office. The feeling of anxiety, scared, excitement, all at the same time. I could see several screens lined up showing red and green flashlights, people reading newspapers, the smell of tea in the entire office, and you could hear the TV news on and on. It was beautiful. Those were the days where my love affair with stock markets started. Greetings, my fellow friends, respected speakers. You know, in my entire childhood, my dad used to explain to me about stock markets, that how companies are listed here and how their share prices go up and down. I used to get so fascinated as a kid, I used to be after his life. Dad, is KitKat listed in stock markets? Dad, are Camlin pencils listed in stock markets? Dad, is Kakeda Hotel listed in stock markets? You know, trying to imitate him by reading the Economic Times, waiting for my favorite share price on that price ticker below every news channel. As children, all of us have the craziest of dreams. Some want to be as strong as the Hulk. Some want to be astronauts. And some wanted to be stock market investors. So, you know, as time passed, the 11, 12-year-old me came into higher classes, where the pressure of studies really starts to build up on you. It's the time when we start going to tuitions after school, where our childhood dreams die. Like any other student, when I was about to clear my 12th grade, I only wanted two things from life. First, get a girlfriend. And second, get admission in the best college possible. Being an average student, I graduated with 79% marks. So I think it goes without saying that no good colleges were available to me. You know, I still remember when I got my mark sheet, I was totally blank, with no idea what future holds for me. You know, just thinking about that moment gives me the chills up my spine. After some time, it suddenly struck me that the only thing I was actually better than other people my age was stock markets. So why not pursue my childhood dream and become a stock market investor? Now, no college at that time was offering any course specifically for stock markets. So I thought to myself that why to waste my time and money to study something I don't want? Rather, start working towards my dreams as soon as possible. I decided not to go to college. See, here's the thing. Being a college dropout is cool. Not going to college altogether is a different story. You know, my own friends started mocking me. Dude, tu college nahi ja raha. Khatam bro, khatam. No parties for you. You won't even get a job even if you wanted to. If that was not enough, I was a walking joke in my family. Dekho harsh ja raha hai. Padhoge nahi, usi ki tarah ban jaoge. You know, things went so bad that I stopped meeting friends, family, or just any event where I actually had to interact with people. Koi ye na puch le ki main karta kya hun. I just stopped stepping out of the house. At that time, I got advice that, Harsh, you have two options. Whether to cry about the fact that you are a proclaimed loser, or to be happy about it. Because no matter what you did or how many times you fail, your reputation could not get any lower. So that was the moment I actually just stopped caring what other people had to think about me. You know, in my first year, I did several courses in stock markets. In my second year, I was working in a bank with the marketing team. In my third year, I worked with a fund manager. During all these years, I was actively investing in stock markets. And I have come to realize that stock markets give you the best returns, both from income and wealth point of view. It is clearly the best place to be. People, and I'm sure most of you also, must be hungry to know about stock markets. But there is no source. Some try reading the newspaper, and after reading two lines, whoosh, has this ever happened to you? So today, let's discuss that is stock markets the line for you, and is it worth your time? Now, stock markets as a career is surrounded with misconceptions in our country. If anyone is even slightly interested in markets, people will come with a caution sign. It's a gamble, addiction, abe satta hai ye. People will demotivate you to enter stock markets at every given point. And truth be told, they are not wrong. I have personally seen people getting wiped out here. I have seen people having to sell their homes because of it. So the question that, are stock markets bad? If suppose someone is driving a car and he's over-speeding with it and meets with an accident, would you say it's the car's fault? Or the driver's fault? Stock markets is like a car. It's on us how we drive it. Stock markets are not bad. It's us investors who are making the same mistake again and again. So what are these same mistakes? To explain this, I'll have to explain you another concept. Risk-reward ratio. Now see, this for me is the law of physics, and this will come in handy to you with every aspect of your life. Higher the risk, higher the reward. Lower the risk, lower the reward. In banks, what is the risk you take? Low. What is the reward you get? Low. In stock markets, what is the risk you take? A little high. And what is the reward you get? A little high. Simple. Now you go to any person walking on the street and you ask him that, sir, if you had to start investing in stock markets from this very moment, what profits would you expect? What profits would you aim for? And I can assure you that 95% of them will tell you, double. Sir, triple. Now to chase double and triple, we end up buying penny stocks. Double, triple. What is the reward we want? Very high. What is the risk we'll take? Extremely high. We might get lucky once, twice, or thrice, but once the tables are turned against us, we will get wiped out. The mistakes we are making again and again is that of having extremely high expectations. Now, another common notion is that stock markets is more riskier than taking a job. How many of you have heard about this? Most of you. Everyone must have told you stock markets is more riskier than taking a job. So let's analyze this. Now to get a job, you need to have a skill, education, and training in that particular field. Am I right? Whereas in stock markets, most of the people in our markets are without any formal training and are investing on other people's advice. On one side, we are studying 5 to 6 years for a job. And on the other side, we don't even want to spare 5 minutes for it. Can we expect equal returns? Then how are stock markets more riskier than taking a job? Some people also might argue that stock markets can never be your main source of income. It's just a side income. It's just a hobby. You know, at this point, I don't even want to quote some of the richest people because of stock markets. All I want to say is that my family's main source of income for the past 40 years has been through stock markets. Not by broking, not by advisory, but by simple investing. And it is no rocket science. Let's talk about a country now. What makes a great country great? A great country becomes great by its companies. High number of companies, high number of jobs, high income, high GDP. What does USA have? Apple, Google, Intel, Microsoft. The list is unending. What do all of these companies have in common? All of them were startups at one point of time. Where do startups get their funding from? Stock markets. Do we Indians invest in stock markets? No. Will we have new companies in our country? No. Will our country ever move forward? No. Don't invest your money in NGOs. Invest your time there. Invest your money in stock markets. Apna to bhala karoge, desh ka bhi bhala kar doge. You know, at this point in time, our economy is in the limelight among all the world economies, and God knows it that we are the next superpower. Ladies and gentlemen, we are sitting in a country where people don't have shoes to wear. Just look at the scope of demand we have. It's a land of opportunities, to say the least. All of us sitting here are the luckiest generation who is going to witness the major part of our country's growth. Be sure to take your part of your country's growth by investing in stock markets right now. Warren Buffett, a man with a net worth of $76.7 billion, having earned all his income through stock markets, a man who needs no introduction. His company, Berkshire Hathaway, and I kid you not, from 1965 to 2016, he has earned a profit of 8,84,000%. 8,84,000%. I know it's absolutely ridiculous. But the thing to focus here is that his annual CAGR is 19%. Just 19%. What do we want? Double, triple. You know, Indian markets, after going through all the crashes and after going through all the controversies from 1979 to 2016, have given us a CAGR of 17%. Warren Buffett is earning 19%. Our markets are giving us 17% after everything that has to be in our economy. Let me give you an example. If you are at the age of 20 and you avoid buying a smartphone and invest 30,000 in stock markets right now, and by avoiding 2 cups of coffee every month till the age of 60, you invest 500 per month. After 40 years, when you're about to retire, when you'll reach the age of 60, you'll get a return of 5 crores, 58 lakhs. 5 crores, 58 lakhs. What was the investment made by you? Avoiding 2 cups of coffee a month. Just imagine the returns if you actually increase your investment. You know, this return you'll get in stock markets without even having good knowledge about the markets. And trust me, sky is the limit if you actually start working in this line. There are absolutely no limits to your reach. You know, investing is a journey. I knew the power of compounding in the long term. Now I have discovered it. I knew the power of technicals in the short term. Now I have discovered it. I knew the power of greed and fear. Now I have discovered it. Seeing all these misconceptions around stock markets, me and my brother have made it our sole mission to educate people about stock markets, to educate them about finances, because that is where our education system is clearly lacking. You know, this reminds me a case of my family member. He's in the top 3 positions of a reputed MNC in our country, so we can imagine that his salary is in high numerals. He's about to retire in a year or so. He has no house. no savings, no finances. All his life, he worked for the company's finances, not his own. Today, we are talking about build a life, not a resume. I like to notch it up a bit. Build your finances, not only your company's. And stock markets is that tool in your hand which will build you. I always remember this, that my grandfather always used to tell me that, Harsh, you will always compromise in life if you are financially weak. You want to go on a holiday, but you take the economy seat, not the first class seat. You want to explore the world, but you don't have money to travel abroad. The kid who loved the stockbroker's office, the boy who was mocked by society, is now the man who has found his financial freedom with stock markets. The only question is, when will all of us? Thank you.